Hi everybody, happy Saturday. How you guys doing today? Today is Saturday, March the 4th in the year 2023. If you are new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up. You're watching Allie's View. I am Allie. And guys, this is the end of week number 9. In my 3rd year in the Chris Sain 100K Challenge. And by the way, shout out to Chris and everybody else that even knows about the 100K Challenge, that heard about it back when it started, that may still be trucking along. You guys know for me, I am clawing my way to 100K. Last week, I intended to go ahead and get my first full share of Tesla. Tesla started going down. Shout out to one of the friends here on the channel that shared his perspective on where he thinks it's gonna go. I don't know if it's going to go back that low. He was saying around $130. Who knows? But anyway, it pulled back and I envision it continuing to go north. But when I saw the little pullback, at first it took off and then it started to pull back a little bit. And I thought, well, I'm going to try to get some more added to what I've already got so that I can get my full share. And then I got sidetracked. And when I meant to go in there on Friday, before you know it, Tesla had already ran up a little bit more. So I'm just gonna have to dollar cost average my way on into Tesla until I get my one share, because as you guys know, I've been talking about 4 stocks. I've been talking about Tesla, I've been talking about Amazon, I've been talking about Google, and I've been talking about Shopify. I really, really, really like those 4. They split last year and I just think that they have outstanding potential. In my mind, I believe that in my lifetime, Walmart will be here in my lifetime. And I know you're like, well, where did Walmart come from, Allie? You weren't talking about Walmart as one of your stocks. No, I did not say Walmart as a stock. But I love that company and I really should invest a little bit in Walmart. But Walmart, I feel like, will be around in my lifetime. I feel like Amazon is going to be around in my lifetime. And I also feel like Google. All these others, who knows what will end up happening with them. But those 3, I feel like, I mean, they're ones that everybody has a reason to use them at some point or another, or possibly. And I just feel like they're just going to be around at least for my lifetime. And you guys know I'm planning to live up into the hundreds and be just like this, having fun with you guys. And I always like to joke with you guys and say, if someone is watching the video, I always like to joke with y'all and say, in case someone is watching the video 100 years from now, I always like to let you know what today's date is. Oops, there goes something that just popped up on my screen. By the way, guys, we had a really neat get together today with Terry Ejioma. Today is Saturday, March the 4th in the year 2023. You guys have heard me talk about Terry's course. It's called Trade and Travel, where Terry teaches people technical analysis trading. And of course, she owns all of the intellectual property, obviously, and her teachings. But you can learn and use her strategies to make a lot of money. She teaches people how to make a minimum of $1,000 a day. And people that are in her VIP course, which she is going to be combining, and it's going to be called Trade and Travel 2.0. There is a link in the description. Terry was talking about that. And she's also planning to have a conference again this year. She had one last year in Miami and she's gonna be having another one this year. So if you wanna learn about technical analysis trading, consider taking Terry Ejioma's course. It is called Trade and Travel 2.0. That is the new one. And the price is gonna be going up in a couple of days. So if it's something you've been thinking about, hey, jump on the bandwagon now. And come on over and have some fun. She teaches people technical analysis trading, as I was just saying, how to enter when banks are buying, how to identify buyer levels and seller levels, getting in when banks are buying and selling when banks are selling, or large money. Guys, did you hear that owl in the background? I've heard people say that it's not a good thing when owls are hooting. I've seen an owl before in person. and I hear what sounds like, maybe that's not an owl, but it sounds like it's an owl. Anyway, so this past week, I did not buy the Tesla share. So hopefully the coming week, I will go ahead and start dollar cost averaging in and you guys will look up and we'll have that one share. As far as the call options that I have in the portfolio, I still have those PLTR call options and I still have the ARC that is still in there. I'm still holding those 90 RUNE token. and waiting on the transition of Voyager to Binance. Those of you that know, Voyager went into bankruptcy not long after the Luna debacle. You guys know that's where I had been buying my Luna. And shout out to those of you that are going through this whole journey with me in terms of transitioning from Voyager to Binance. So we'll see how that continues to unfold, and you get to look at what remains in my portfolio. I keep getting these emails about going on ahead and starting the transition if you have a Binance account, and I do have one of those, so I'm probably going to go ahead and start that transition. Also, guys, I keep talking about Upside. I love this neat app. Gas prices have come down some. The average gas price here in the metro Atlanta area is about $3.15 for regular, which is lower than it's been, but I still think that's high. I'd like to see it down into the low to mid twos, if not lower, back like it was in the beginning of 2020. You guys remember when we had all that oil out there in the ocean stockpiled and gas prices were really, really low? I'd love to see that again. Wouldn't that be grand? but Upside is a really neat link that allows you, if you buy gas at one of the stations that support the Upside app, to get money back. And if you use my referral link, you'll get 15 cents in addition to whatever the gas station is offering. So please consider it. There is a link in the description. Also, guys, you guys have heard me talking about these three different books that I have created. The first, because we talk about trading here on Allie's View, is something that I enjoy doing, and many of you do as well. It's a trading journal created by your girl Allie. And there's two different color waves. There's the black one and there's the gold one. but the information that's inside is the same. So you basically get an overview, and then you get a place for you to make note of your investment plan. You get a place for you to put your trading system, and as well as notes, then your monthly goals, whatever they may be. And then the bulk of the book actually is made up of trading log, like as you enter and exit trades. And that's what, like I said, the bulk of the book consists of. So thank you to those who have already picked up one of these. And if you're interested, there is a link in the description. It is available on Amazon. And also, I love to talk about my personal emergency log, because I think this is a very useful resource for you to make note of important information. Like, I call it like a life management journal. Where you can put all about yourself, all about you, your important family documents, family information, emergency information, just things that I thought were useful. And my friends and I and my family, we've been using it. Your financial information, credit card information. A lot of times we put information in our smartphones and we put it in our iPad or on our computer, and then all of a sudden something happens to the electronic device, and before you know it, you've lost your information. And then you're ready to have a hissy fit. And especially with these iPhones, sometimes you guys probably have seen a video that I did where the notes tend to disappear. And we found a neat way to be able to get them back. But that's something, Apple, if you're watching this video, get that fixed. That Apple really needs to look into getting fixed. But anyway, place for your medical information, your pet information. We can't leave out the pets. Can't leave out our pets. Any irreplaceable documents and service and utility information. Place for family member portraits. There's a couple of pages for all of that as well. And one thing that I consider to be very important, also your internet tracker passwords. You know, we have all these passwords now that we've turned into a digital world. Also a place for your last wishes, like where do you want to have your funeral? Do you even want to have a funeral? All that kind of stuff I thought was useful and very important. So you can get my personal emergency log created by yours truly, Allie, on Amazon. You hear that? Listen to that sound. What is that? Is that, to me, it sounds like an owl. I don't know. But anyway, it's your girl Allie. If you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. And guys, like I said, didn't do a lot this past week. I'm still clawing my way to 100K. One of these days, you guys are going to look up and be like, whoa, Allie just hit the number. it's not going to be that fast, but you're going to look up. I'm going to make some moves and we're going to skyrocket. Watch. If you're new to the channel, like I said, hit the subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, and take a look at the t-shirts, the Let's Go t-shirts. There should be a link down there below. Your girl set up one of those little Teespring shops, and the Let's Go t-shirts, since that's one of my favorite things to say here on Allie's View. Let's go. Without any further ado, have a great rest of your day. Let's go. Okay, everybody, here we are inside of my portfolio. As I shared, we are at the end of week number 9 in the Chris Sain Challenge. My third year. If you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. Like I said, not a lot going on, guys, here at the portfolio. We'll see what continues to unfold. No real changes here. Stay tuned. We're going to get this thing to skyrocket and push our way past $2,000. That's what our sights are set on here. As far as taking a look at the crypto.com, every time I turn around, they need an update. So, goody, this one did not need an update. I knew it. I should have done this previous to doing the video. But here we go. They are updating. While they're updating, let's move on and go look in Voyager while they're updating. You guys know that Voyager has filed for bankruptcy, and they are now, from what I've read, going to be transitioning assets into Binance. So what you see here should be making its way over to Binance. Of course, you guys know we've been watching this whole Luna mess. And you can kind of see where it is right now. So the Rune is the other one that I have that we've been looking at. And it still has the potential for life, I believe. That's why I haven't transitioned out of it. but you guys can see right now it's at $1.42. I've still got those 90 Rune token. Not a lot going on, guys. Like I said, if you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. I am clawing my way to 100K. And I thank you guys so much for sticking with me and giving me your insight and just coming along with me for the journey, and not just what I'm doing in the Chris Sain Challenge. Many of you have come to see what happens with that, and I do thank you. And others of you are just kind of going along with me, and I can't thank you enough. So let's continue our journey together. Have a great rest of your day. Let's go. Okay, everybody, here we are inside of my portfolio. As I shared, we are at the end of week number 9 in the Chris Sain Challenge. My third year,